Corey, the manager mentioned how important that first meeting was. What sort of things did he say that enthused you? Because he said you really were, you seemed to be gripped by what he was saying.
Yeah, definitely. It's just, you know, it's just the way he come across. I think, you know, when you sit in front of a manager, it's, you know, important you get a feel for what they want to do moving forward. And you can sit there and some things can go in one ear out the other when you're not really taken to what someone's saying to you. But I was intrigued the whole meeting, you know, the moving forward, the way where he wants the club to be, where he's already proven the club can be. You know, obviously Christmas time last season, it was in a really good place, and barring different reasons, kind of couldn't contain that. But I think this group of players and what he was telling me and what we've got as an outfit, I think that just struck to me straight away that I wanted to be a part of it.
How good is it for a player to have a meeting like that and know when you walk away, okay, that's it?
Yeah, it's refreshing, yeah, because you know, you've sat in meetings beforehand that haven't gone as well, and you'll sit in many more that don't. So to sit in one where it's refreshing and you like what you hear, and you know, you really want to be a part of something, and you think in the next couple of days we could potentially have something over the line, it was nice to walk away and feel wanted by a football club.
You mentioned it earlier, how good is it to get it done when you've got pre-season coming up just a matter of days away? You know what you're doing now for the next 2 years.
Yeah, definitely. It's obviously, you know, like you say, you can be a long summer and you can, you know, be picking up the phone, answering phone calls, not quite got something over the line. But in terms of how quickly this, you know, kind of caught fire, and now obviously coming in on the first day of pre-season, I know I'll be a Carlisle player now and for the future.
Fair to say you're at an age now where you really want to lay the marker down, you want to show people what you're about?
Yeah, definitely. I think I'm at an age where, you know, I need to almost, now I've been away and stuff, but now I'm back in England and, you know, I want to get the ball rolling again, and, you know, I know what I can do as a player, but it's just being able to give a platform to show that. And I think this football club, barring form and if I'm doing the right things on and off the pitch, I think this football club can give me that.
Manager mentioned versatility anywhere across the back four, even as a holding midfielder if you needed. Yeah. How would you describe yourself? Which is your preferred position?
Preferred positions, it's a question I get asked a lot, but I don't really have one because I've played in so many, and it's something that I've always took with me through my career, is the fact that I can play in more than one position, and you know, that helps me in some ways, because you know, if someone's doing really well in one position, you know, I might get a look in at another position. Or, but in terms of stamping one down, I'm still at a stage where I'm just adaptable, and I'll adapt to things, you know, at the start of games, during games, within games. I just want to adapt. So yeah, I don't really have a preferred position. I just think I can do most positions around the defensive quite well.
You mentioned where we were at Christmas. That came about high energy, high pressing, everybody working as a unit. Is that your preferred style again?
Yeah, definitely. I've been at clubs that have done that, obviously growing up at Liverpool, especially when the transition of the manager and how they want to play high pressing football, it's not something that's foreign to me. I've done it before. Out in America was the same thing. It was high pressing, play in intensity, move the ball quick, press quick, get in people's faces. So yeah, it's nothing that's foreign to me. So obviously when I heard that was refreshing to hear as well.
Liverpool, Corey, it doesn't get any better for a grounding in the game. You must have learned so much.
Yeah, I did. It was, you know, I spent the best part of 11 years at the club, and, you know, I wouldn't change any of it, really. I've worked with some of the best coaches, the best people, you know, got experience in training with, you know, what people would call established Premier League footballers. So, you know, who wouldn't learn in that environment? Because, you know, once you're thrown into it, it's kind of like, right, this is it now. You know, you've got to kind of, you know, prove what you can do. So, yeah, it taught me loads on and off the pitch, watching how, you know, some of the Premier League players prepare for training and stuff like that. It just teaches you a lot. So yeah, no, it really gave me good grounding and set me in good stead.
As good as that is, does it reach a point where you think to yourself, right, I need to move now because I've got a career to look after?
No, definitely, yeah. I think obviously I kind of hit that point at the age of 21, and I knew then that, you know, I have to go and look after myself now. It's okay being around a club like Liverpool, and some players will struggle to, you know, let go of the fact that they're not a Liverpool player anymore. But for me, I understood that, you know, it wasn't where I was going to progress as a footballer, but barring the training and the good people you associate yourself around every day, it was, now I need to get my career kick-started. So yeah, like, that's what I had to go and do, and I feel like now I've landed in this position, fortunate position, that I'm ready to do that now.
Talk about letting go. You let everything go, and off you went to America for 18 months or whatever. Yeah. It was. How much did you grow as a person having done that out there?
Yeah, loads. I think it, you know, it taught me a lot, not even in football terms as well, of course, but it taught me a lot about just life in general. I think off the pitch stuff, you know, I was out there on my own for large parts of it. So, you know, when you're in a environment that's not, you know, it was foreign to me, you know, even the way the people were a lot different to back home and stuff like that. they eat different things, just little things that you don't think would probably play a huge part. But now the football side of things out there was brilliant for me. You know, I worked closely with like you say, Peter Ramage and stuff, and ultimately we were successful. We won, you know, two trophies out there in my time there. So bringing that home with me, again, I wouldn't have changed anything out there. So I enjoyed the experience.
You like a challenge. You come back to a club that's going into administration. It's fighting relegation. What's that like?
Yeah, different in so many ways. Again, you know, January comes around. It's that kind of time for a footballer where you want to, you know, you want to be in somewhere, especially for me coming home in the November and stuff and having Christmas and getting that out of the way. January, obviously another challenge come about, and you know, I was a Wigan player at the end of January, and then again it's a different challenge. Then it's not as successful, you know, pushing for leagues and winning things. It's kind of like, no, you need to keep this football club in the league. And I think we got a group of players together that was, you know, a great group on and off the pitch, and I think that's what ultimately pushed us to, you know, to staying in the league when we did. And it was great, you know, obviously at the end of the whole game when we eventually knew we'd stayed in League One as a club, it was great, you know, smiles on people's faces, and to know that we give something back to the club in such a hard time was, you know, rewarding in itself.
Something else that stuck out from what the manager said, you've told him you're not here to make up the numbers, you want to play your part.
No, definitely, yeah. I'm not here to make up numbers, you know, it's healthy competition at every football club, and, you know, you understand that as a player the older you get. And yeah, so I'm ready to hit the ground running, and I'm sure the other lads coming back into pre-season are as well. So if we all push in that one direction, I'm sure the club will be in a great place.
And you can look around and see when the fans are here, this is going to be a great place to be. Really looking forward to this challenge.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, just being here today and, you know, coming to see the stadium and meet the manager again and the staff and, you know, all you guys, it's, you know, the club is obviously something that, you know, I wanted to be a part of. As I said yesterday, sitting down, it was kind of like, it wasn't like, let me think about it. It was kind of like, when we getting this done kind of thing, because it was something that I really wanted to be over the line, and I just can't wait to, you know, have a packed stadium here on a Saturday or a Tuesday, and then, you know, winning games for the football club.
Next step, Corey, is to meet the lads. Obviously, you'll know Zach, but do you get nervous at all with these situations and coming in to meet a new group?
No, not really. It's not something, you know, it's just another group of lads that, you know, you're going to be playing football with over weekend, and you want to all pushing for the same thing. So there's no nerves on my part. Obviously, you know, first impressions as people anyway are always key, so you want to give off a good first impression. But you know, I'm an easygoing lad, and you know, I get on with anybody. So yeah, I just can't wait to meet them all on Friday, really.
A couple of weeks of picking your lungs up off the floor at the end of each day. You're looking forward to that part of it?
Yeah, it's always a thought. I'm more nervous about that than the lads, to be fair. But no, it was pre-season's one of them times where, you know, it's made for getting your body into shape. You like to think you do it in the off-season. Of course, it's more difficult because you're not in a routine. You've got to kind of do it off your own back. But yeah, I think everyone will come in relatively sharp, and you know, we'll just look to and then get the ball out again and get onto a level as a team in terms of football and where we're going to push and how we're going to play for the season. So yeah, obviously there'll be hard parts, of course, it's pre-season, you'd expect that, but yeah, on a whole, you know, we've just got to enjoy it and enjoy being back playing football again.
And just finally, Corey, it's the fixture release on Thursday, is that when it gets real?
Yeah, definitely, you know, you always look out for that, you always look where you're playing your first game in the league, and you know, who you're playing, where it's at, and yeah, there's one eye on that, of course. And you know, I'm sure when the fixtures come out Thursday, that's when we'll all sit down and, you know, we'll start to get a plan in place of what we're going to do and how we're going to attack it. But until then, obviously, it's back to the drawing, a bit more running for me before Friday, and then, yeah, come in and ready to hit the ground running.
Super. Welcome to the club, and thanks for your time.